For his new TV show, comedian Sacha Baron Cohen managed to trick multiple lawmakers into supporting a fake program that advocated, for example, putting guns in the hands of toddlers, preschoolers. But Florida Congressman Matt Gaetz, he didn't fall for it.
I sat down with the House representative and outlined my common sense proposal.
Oh, you want me to say on television that I support 3- and 4-year-olds with firearms? Is that what you're asking me to do?
Yes.
You can do. Typically, members of Congress don't just hear a story about a program and then indicate whether they support it or not.
Wow, Florida Congressman, a member of the House Judiciary Committee, Matt Gaetz, joins us right now. Good to have you with us. Unbelievable.
Good to be on. And, you know, Sacha Baron Cohen brought a mastery level of deception.
At what point did you know you were duped?
Well, I guess when I got a call from some media reporters asking if I had been interviewed by Sacha Baron Cohen. But, you know, to be honest, I think that politicians should take the work that we do very seriously, but we should not take ourselves so seriously that we can't have a laugh in a circumstance like this.
But, Congressman, how did he get to you? How did he get to Dick Cheney? How did he get to Bernie Sanders? I mean, just by the line?
No, they were good. They set up fake websites. They indicated that they were presenting awards to members of Congress and other public officials for their support for the U.S.-Israel relationship. They said they simply wanted to tape the presentation of that award. And then when the cameras are rolling, they were asking people to read off of a teleprompter and to hold up images of weapons and to say what they wanted them to say. I would like to thank my mother for giving me a very healthy dose of skepticism when people ask you to do strange things.
So how did that play out, the moment you realize, all right, this guy is who I think it is, and this is a complete joke? How did you handle it?
You know, there are a number of strange things that happen every day on Capitol Hill, and so I just thought it was maybe another kind of weird, bizarre foreign media interview. It really wasn't until months later that I obtained the realization that that was Sacha Baron Cohen. I wish I would have known it was him in real time, because then I could have traded Borat impressions with him. I was a big fan of that movie.
So you knew Borat. You would recognize him, but you still didn't in that moment make the connection. That's how good he is.
Good makeup artistry, good acting by Sacha Baron Cohen. And yeah, I mean, they catch members of Congress at the end of the day, a little frustrated, a little tired. And I think they got some of my colleagues to say some things they likely regret.
Including Trent Lott and this guy, Larry Pratt, gun guy. So he's out to embarrass you. And I think he mildly embarrassed Bernie Sanders as well. Congressman, let me ask you to weigh in on what's going on right now. Do you look for the president to clarify his comments today?
I look for the president to maybe illuminate a little further the progress that was made in the closed door session. President Trump has indicated that non-proliferation really was the signature objective of this summit. And if we can make progress in North Korea and Iran, if we can obtain some sense of normalcy in Syria so that people can return home, those are the real things that impact quality of life. And I could tell you back home, we are doing a lot of work on election resiliency that doesn't get coverage in the media with the Homeland Security Committee and with our state and local officials. I think the president was right to bring up the issue of election meddling with Vladimir Putin. I believe the intelligence community is correct that Russia engages in their malign influence campaign all over the world. And I think going forward, let's try to build on the successes of this summit, particularly in the areas of nonproliferation and anti-terrorism.
All right, we'll leave it there. Congressman Gaetz, good to have you on. No fooling
Thanks
you, apparently.
Right. Thank you.